As of December 15, New South Wales looks like leading the way, trying to get rid of QR codes and what is effectively a vaccine passport. You're going to allow the unvaccinated to have similar rights in pubs and restaurants as the vaccinated. Now, I'd argue we should be able to do that now at the rates we've got, but it's going to be December the 15th. Are you confident that those restrictions will never be put back in place, demanding booster shots or updated shots with new strains and the like?
What I'm confident about, Chris, is that our government is focused on taking proportionate measures to keep people safe and get our economy through. That's what we've done the whole way through this pandemic. And it's why New South Wales has come out of it in better shape than arguably anywhere else in the country. So we'll take proportionate decisions that protect people's freedoms but keep people safe. That's what we're doing here in this state. And the proof's in the pudding, Chris. We've been enjoying freedom longer than most people. Our economy is getting back on its feet. In fact, we've got the highest rate of business confidence anywhere in the country at the moment because of the decisions this government has taken. So again, we want to keep people safe. We want to keep people out of hospital. We don't want to see people getting sick. But we also need to do things in a proportionate way that will ensure that our economy is able to reopen, grow, create jobs and drive forward to the future.
Given the vaccination rates that we've got across the country, over 90% in Victoria as well now and in the ACT, the other states have had plenty of warning but are still over 80% and rising, shouldn't we be looking at the sort of pullback of restrictions you're looking at in a couple of weeks in New South Wales? Shouldn't they be happening nationally now? Haven't we got Queensland, West Australia, to some degree South Australia as well, really holding back unnecessarily on opening up?
Well, that's a matter for those governments. But here in New South Wales, we respect people's freedoms. We want to get our economy going. And while they're shutting their borders, I'm sticking my hand up to get the investment, to get the jobs, and to turbocharge our prosperity. So if they want to be hermit kingdoms, that's up to them. We want to grow investment, we want to grow our economy and grow the prosperity of every person in this state, but do it in a safe way, and that's why we're taking a proportionate approach to how we reopen.
Now, I've been talking to business leaders. They're really worried about how they're going to get people coming back to the office. There's a lot of resistance. You're standing in the middle of the Sydney CBD now. It's going to rain there for about the next 3 days solid. But when the rain stops, how are you going to re-enliven the CBD, get people back into the city?
Well, we've just announced a $2.8 billion stimulus package to support businesses, particularly in our CBDs, not just here in the city, but also in Western Sydney, the Parramatta CBD, for example. We want to get business back to business and people back to work. And one of the great ways you can do that by is enlivening our cities, getting people back into the office block. That supports all the small businesses, the cafe owners, the restaurant owners. That's what we're focused on. That's why today we announced our $250 million Dine and Discover vouchers, so two $25 vouchers for every registered person in New South Wales to encourage them to go to restaurants in town, to go to cafes, go out and have a good time and stimulate our economy while doing so.